excited. I'm excited that you're here tonight. I'm excited the Holy Spirit is here tonight. He is here tonight. I feel His presence already. Whatever you need, it's here. Whatever you need tonight, whatever deliverance, whatever breakthrough, whatever healing you need, it's here tonight. So I encourage you to step into the water tonight. Let it flow all over you. Touch your life tonight, because my prayer is that you're going to leave here differently than the way you've come in tonight. Praise God. We're so excited about having Brother Jonathan tonight and his brother Ben and Dustin. And all they're going to do our praise and worship tonight. They're going to do singing tonight. We're just going to have camp meeting at its best. Amen. Praise the Lord. So let's get in and get behind these guys tonight. And I want to take up prayer requests tonight. I got a couple serious ones that's been given in to me today. Let's remember Miss Judy Fixico. Many remembers Eddie and Wendy Crownover. Eddie's brother Jeffrey, they found him dead a couple days ago. Pray for him, shock to the family. And then this morning about 3 o'clock, about 3 a.m., Wendy's little brother had a car wreck and was still water and was killed instantly. So Eddie lost a brother and she lost a brother all within 2 days. So let's remember the Crownover family tonight and the Fixico and the Herring family. And many know Miss Dixie at the Dairy Hut. Well, that would be her son. And so let's pray for Dixie tonight. I know they sure use it right now. They need our prayers. So anyway, keep holding up these tonight. If anybody else has got a prayer, like, we want to get them in. All right, Toby Alsop had his funeral, his sister's funeral yesterday. So remember Toby and Neva tonight as well. Anybody? All right. Remember Natalie's mom and dad, both of them were extremely sick over the weekend, so keep them in their prayers tonight. And so whenever they're sick, that puts a burden on Natalie. So pray for her as well tonight. Anybody else tonight? Pray for Sister Rhonda tonight. Amen. Keep Brother Baker in our prayers tonight. And Johnny Townsend, keep him in our prayers. How about got some unsaved loved ones tonight, though? We just want to see brought in the kingdom of God and families, and praise God, and unspoken requests tonight. God is able. He's big enough. He's big enough to meet your every need tonight. Amen. Pray for healing of allergies and asthma going on around this place, and colds and flu and pneumonia, that God would bring deliverance. Amen. We need that tonight. So let's just stand at our camp meeting tonight. We just pray for our hearts and lives. Father, we love you. Lord, what a privilege. What a privilege it is to come into the holies of holies tonight. Lord, we step beyond the holy place. We step behind the veil tonight. Lord, to have a fresh encounter, to sup, Lord, with the bread of life. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for the living water tonight. Lord, the living water, Lord, that is flowing in this house of worship tonight. Lord, I pray for hearts to be united as one. Lord, we pray for the wind of heaven to begin to blow tonight as a mighty rushing wind. Lord, I pray breathing upon hearts, Lord, baptizing, Lord, in the Holy Ghost tonight, God, Lord, and filling and refilling tonight. Father, we pray for healing in this place tonight. Lord, we pray healing of the lungs. Lord, healing in the knees, healing in the back. Lord, healing of sciatic nerves tonight. Lord, bring in healing right now. Lord, Father, I pray for all the youth and teenagers tonight. Lord, that your Holy Spirit will begin to manifest tonight. Lord, all those that's watching by the way of Facebook and media church tonight, Lord, I ask your blessing to touch in that living room right where they are. Lord, in the automobiles are driving down the road tonight. Father, I pray the power of God, Lord, to just transcend against all space and time. Lord, that your Holy Spirit knows no limits tonight. Father, we pray for healing upon that has lost loved ones. Lord, that you would comfort them tonight. Lord, that your Holy Spirit, Lord, would just wrap your arms around them. Lord, give them the grace that is needed in making every decision. Father, I pray meet financial needs tonight. Lord, bring us closer to you, Lord. Father, bring us, Lord, touch our nation, Lord. Lord, we're in need of a reviving, God. We're in need tonight, Lord, of a touch from God. Father, I pray for the peace of Jerusalem tonight. Lord, that you have blessed Israel, Lord. Bless your mighty people tonight. Father, we thank you for the church of the living God, your bride. Lord, the glorious. Lord, tonight, Lord, as we step in, Lord, we step into the veil, Lord, it's just to wrap your arms around you and just say, Lord, we love you. And Lord, we thank you tonight for what you're going to do. Lord, as your anointing, Lord, as your anointing has come for such a time as this, Lord, we love you. We magnify you tonight. We give you all the praise for it. In Jesus' holy, holy, holy name. And the whole church body said amen. The scripture is this, Psalms 97. The Lord reigneth, and let the earth rejoice. Let the multitude of isles be glad thereof. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Righteousness and judgment are the habitation of his throne. And a fire goes before him and burneth up his enemies round about. Woo! How many are up for that Holy Ghost fire tonight? Let's praise and worship the Lord tomorrow. Lord, come on. Let's have camp meeting tonight.
Well, there is power, power. There's wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, there's power, there's wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. In the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there's power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your passion and pride? Or in the blood, blood, come for a cleansing to Calvary's side. There's wonderful power in the blood. Sing it out, church. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there's power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be whiter, much whiter than snow? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Sin stains are lost in its life. There's wonderful power in the blood. There's power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you do service for Jesus, your King? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. And would you live daily his praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. Sing it out, church. Oh, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, power, there's wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Sing that chorus again. Oh, there is power, power, there's wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, there's wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. So have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in his grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? And are you washed in the blood, soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you walking daily by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? And do you
rest each moment in the crucified. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood.
Yes, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. And are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? When the bridegroom cometh, will your robes be white? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? And will your soul be ready for the mansions that are bright? And be washed in the blood of the Lamb? Sing it out, church. Are you washed?
Are you washed
in the blood?
In the blood.
In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? We'll lay aside the garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Holy wash in the blood of the Lamb. Are you washed?
Are you washed
in the blood?
In the blood.
In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. And are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? And are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. Why don't you turn around to somebody, share a handshake and a smile. Would you do that? Find somebody you haven't shook hands with yet tonight. Can I get a little more piano?
Life is over, yes, I'm gonna fly away.
Anybody gonna fly away?
We're to a home on God's celestial shore.
Well, Lord,
I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh, glory, yes, I'll fly away.
Gonna fly away.
Away in the morning now and when I die.
Hallelujah,
by and by and by.
Fly away.
Well, and when the shadows of this life have grown, yes, I'll fly away. Well, like a bird from these prison bars has flown, oh, yes, I'll fly away. Sing it out now and I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away.
Gonna fly away.
Morning, oh yes, when I die,
hallelujah,
by and by,
I'll fly away,
when I die, and when I die,
hallelujah, by and by,
I'll
fly away.
Amen. You may be seated for a minute because I lost piano. The piano died. Did I kill it? I didn't. There's nothing up here. The piano flew away.
Is the power on?
Yeah, it just stopped.
No, I'm saying, oh, it did shut off.
Shut it back off on and on.
I see lights.
And we're back.
I have never killed a piano before. That's a first for me. I've seen guys break the strings of the real pianos, but I have never played a piano hard enough to where it just shut down. It said, I'm done.
I'm not going on. You play me like that, I'm done. Are y'all sure this is a Pentecostal pinner?
If it wasn't, it's going to be now.
I don't know. Well, let's do that again, guys, and see how long we can let it go again. All right, let's do that. What's the next verse on that I'll Fly Away? I forget it all the time.
Well, it's just a few more happy days and then, oh, I'll fly away. Well, to a land where joy shall never end. Oh, yes, I'll fly away. Fly away, gonna fly away in the morning. Oh yes, when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Play one right now.
Song. I heard an old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary, well, to save a wretch like me. Well, I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood atoning. Oh, then I repented of my sin, and I won the victory.
Come on, sing, church,
oh, victory. And Jesus, my Savior, forever. He saw me, and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me, ere I knew him. All my love is to him. Oh, yes, he plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing.
I heard about a mansion.
I heard about a mansion. A mansion that he has built for me way up in glory. Oh, and I heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea. Oh, about the angels singing and that old redemption story. Oh, and some sweet day I'm gonna sing up there the song of victory.
Come on, church, sing it out.
Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior. He saw me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He launched me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Oh yes, he plunged me.
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah.
Well, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Well, I promised him that I will serve him till I die, and I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Do it again.
Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Oh, I am on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I promised him that I would serve him till I die, and I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Well, I promised him that I would serve him till I die, and I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Well, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Are y'all glad to be here tonight? About 50% of you. That's good. That's good. That's okay. It went off and on again. I think I'm just hitting it too hard. I don't know. There's a song we've been doing at our church that I just love. And I'm glad that all my hope is in Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Acts, in him we move and breathe and have our being. I want to tell you something tonight. I can only be here because of Jesus Christ. I can only sit down at this piano and sing these songs because of Jesus Christ. If had not been for the Lord on my side, I don't know where I'd be tonight. Let's do this song, guys.
I've been healed by the Savior. I feel fire from above. Be the same, 'cause all of my hope is in Jesus, and all my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. All of my sins, all of my sins are forgiven.
Are you glad about that?
Oh, and I've been washed by the blood. I'm no stranger to prison. I've worn shackles and chains.
Oh, I like this.
And I've been freed and forgiven. Oh, I'll never be the same. That's why I sing that all of my hope is in Jesus.
Aren't you glad, church?
Thank God my yesterday's gone. All of my sins, now all of my sins are forgiven.
I've been washed.
I've been washed by the blood.
Sing that chorus again. All of my hope is in Jesus.
All of my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. All of my sins and all of my sins are forgiven. And I've been washed by the blood. Oh, and I've been washed by blood. Oh, yes, I've been washed by the blood.
If you've been washed by the blood, let the Lord know. Give him praise tonight in this place. All my hope is in Jesus Christ. Give a. Dustin, I want you to sing that song that you were singing.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice to the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside,
there's a better life.
There's a better life. There's a better life. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. Listen. Oh, if you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking saver. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. And we've all found ourselves worn out by the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. But there's a better life. There's a better life. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. You need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. You got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you believe in, you receive it. If you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, then you receive it. If you can feel it, somebody testify. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison-shaking savior. If you've got chains, he's a chain-breaker. If you need freedom, if you need freedom or saving, he's a prison-shaking savior. If you've got chains, he's a chain-breaker.
What's that other one?
If there's anybody that wants to sit down, you're welcome to. If you want to stand up, please continue doing that. Whatever you want to do. Amen. Just be obedient to Jesus. Be obedient to the Holy Ghost tonight. Amen. I love this song.
He counts the stars one and all. He knows how much sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that falls.
Listen.
He made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. And he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, and every tear that I cry. And he knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the light of day. I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my name. I don't know what tomorrow may bring. I can't tell you what's in store, 'cause I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers for the questions in life, but I'll know in whom I believe. He knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, and every tear that I cry. And he knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain, and I can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine. Thank you. knows how much sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. He knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I aren't you glad he knows your name? He knows my name. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain, I can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine. He knows my name.
You know what? You're so important to Jesus that if you're his child and it matters to you, it matters to him. And he absolutely knows your name. He knows what you're going through. So many of you walked in tonight and you had this big old smile in the midst of a big old trial. Listen, it's okay to hurt. Just make sure you fall into the arms of Jesus every time you're hurting. I see so many people that mess up and they're hurting and they run from Jesus. When Pastor, he's the one to run to because he knows your name. You matter to him. Listen, what he would absolutely not even do for the angels, he did for you and you and you and you and you and every one of us. Pastor, he wouldn't even do it for the angels. That's how much he loves you. I wish we could just get it through our heads how much we mean to the Lord. Just let him hold you. I don't know what tomorrow may bring. I can't tell you what's in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers to the questions in life. But here's the important part. But I know in whom I believe. He knows my name. Every step that I take. Every move that I make, every tear that I cry, and he knows my name. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain, when I can't see the light of day, I know I'll be just fine, cause he knows my name. Lord, the Bible says to cast all your cares. Brother Ben, what did you always say? What does all mean in the Greek?
Yeah, all.
It just means all. Quit trying to break it down and figure things out so much. Just trust God when he says something. Cast all your cares on him, for he cares for you. He cares for you. Don't give him 98%, 99%, 99.9% and hold back that one. What is that? Help me out here. 1/100th? 1/10th? Help me out. It's been a long time since I've been in school. Give him every bit. Every bit. So many of us have this secret place in our heart that we won't even let God go. Brother Jonathan, we hide it from God. He needs to see it all. He's the only one that can know our heart. Who could know what the Bible says? It's desperately wicked. God knows it. Give it all to him.
Because he counts the stars, one and all. Jesus knows how much sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that falls.
Pastor, he made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small.
He knows my name.
I know you know it now. Sing it.
Every step that I take,
every move that I make,
every move,
every tear that I cry, he knows my name. Sing it to the Lord. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain and I can't see the light of day, I know I'll be just fine, because he knows my name. Sing it one more time. Let heaven hear you. Every move that you make, every single tear that you cry.
He knows my name
when I'm overwhelmed, when I can't even see the light of day. Listen,
I know I'll be just fine, 'cause He knows my name.
Thank you, Lord.
The fear.
us to do this one. It's an old Dottie Rambo song. Y'all remember Dottie Rambo? Let's do that.
Just about home time. I can see my father standing at the door. This world in a wilderness, I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
Sing it.
Table spread in splendor, and someone standing by the open door. I can see a crystal river, Lord, I must be near forever. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. We'll see the bright light shine, it's just about home time. I can see my father standing at the door. This world's been a wilderness, I'm ready for deliverance. Oh Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
Sing it again, sing that verse again. There's a light in the window.
Well, there's a light in the window. The table spread its splendor. Someone standing by the open door. I can see crystal river, so I must be near forever. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. We'll see the bright light shine, it's just about home time. Oh, I can see my father standing at the door. This world's been a wilderness, I'm ready for deliverance. Oh Lord, I've never been this home sick before. One more time. We'll see the bright light shine, it's just about home time. Oh, I can see my father standing at the door. This world's been a wilderness, I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. Oh Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
We're plowing now, folks. Woo, I see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. Woo, my Lord. I tell you, if you don't like church down here, you ain't gonna like what's gonna happen up there, folks. Come on, so I said, if you ain't like what's happening down here, you're not gonna like what's gonna happen over yonder. I know it's home time. And the blessed Savior is about to come gather the redeemed home. Hallelujah. My, my, my. Give these guys a big God bless you tonight. Wow, wow, wow. You are blessed, folks. You are blessed tonight. This is some of the finest in Oklahoma you're getting right here tonight. Yo, by internet, I hope you're enjoying this tonight. My, this is Ben Scroggs and his singing group tonight. Book them. Book them. My, 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 my. Get them in your church. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is so good tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you guys for coming out tonight, but still there's yet to come. We've not heard the word yet. Hallelujah. We're just getting the heart. We're just getting the heart broke up tonight, so let the word of God find a good place to settle down in and rest and take root. Amen. Brother Jonathan Scroggs is going to come and preach the word for us, but before he comes, we're going to take up a love offering for him and his family tonight. So, praise God. Let's sow a good seed tonight. Expect a harvest. Expect a return on it. I tell you, Brother Jonathan is a man of God. He's making a difference in the kingdom. He's making a difference in God's kingdom. Very humble man, spirit-led, spirit-filled, preaching the gospel. And so we're blessed tonight to have him and come and minister to us tonight. So we're going to bless him. If I can have our ushers come on down tonight. Praise the Lord for you guys. And while we take up the offering tonight, we're going to remember and we're going to pray for Brother Mark Fox. He is in the hospital in OU Medical in Edmond, Oklahoma. And so we're going to pray for him now. So I want you to stand up and I want you to join hands because he's our speaker for Tuesday night. And the enemy is trying to attack his health. Come on, somebody, help me out tonight. We ain't going to allow this. We're not going to allow the enemy to afflict God's people with an illness. We're going to take authority and we're going to take the charge tonight over this. And we're going to rebuke that old sickness of tonight and pray for healing and deliverance so he can be here Tuesday night. My. Father, we love you. Lord, we come together right now. Lord, we come in the name that's above every name. Father, I thank you for the anointing of God, Lord, that destroys every yoke. Lord, this affliction, Lord, it shall not rise upon him a second time. Lord, we take authority right now. We take the dominion, Lord, over every sickness, over every disease, over every infirmity tonight. Lord, and we cast it out right now in Jesus' name. Lord, you said to lay hands upon the sick and they shall recover. Father, I am praying for total health tonight. Lord, you said I am the God that healeth thee tonight, that healeth Brother Mark Fox. Father, we take that authority. We take your word on it right now. Father, I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood, Lord, every stripe that you bore at Calvary, Lord, for our healing in this house tonight. Lord, we thank you that deliverance has come. Lord, and I just pray over this offering tonight, Lord, that you would bless it. Lord, that you would multiply it. Father, I thank you for blessing tonight, God, blessing the giver. Lord, blessing the recipient of it tonight. Father, bless his family. Lord, bless them tonight. Father, we ask it all in Jesus' holy, wonderful name, and the whole church body said amen. Amen. Brother Jonathan, come on down, my friend. I tell you what, don't you love Brother Jonathan? Well, you got one fan, brother. You got one, brother. Woo! Amen. I tell you, what a guy. What a guy. Loves the Lord, and he loves you tonight. We're glad to have. So let's give him a big old yell. God bless you. Give him your undivided attention tonight.
That one that hollered out when he asked if don't y'all love Jonathan, I'll give you your $5 bill at your church. Thank you for filling that awkward silence there for a minute. It was awkward for me as well. No, I understand. It's good to be here tonight. It's been about a year since the last time I got to preach here. Now, I've been here since then for Sister Myrtle. And it wasn't her funeral. It was her celebration of life. And, man, what a celebration that woman had. Brother Bob Lynch's mama, such a precious woman. And was she 100 yet or was she 99? Oh, she was already 100 and turning 101 right before Jesus went ahead and allowed her to come on home. And that was the last time I was here. And before that, I got to preach last year at camp meeting. I'm going to be quite honest with y'all. One thing you're going to find out about me, I'm not as refined as my brother, Pastor Ben Scroggs. My brother Ben, he gets tired of probably hearing it, but he's my hero. I love my brother Ben. I look up to my brother Ben. Sometimes I can't stand my brother Ben, but that's just part of loving people, right? And he'll testify the same for his little brother. I probably annoy him a lot. But speaking of little brothers, y'all, that was my nephew, Jaden, singing beside me, 14 years old, and his little brother, Ethan, 12 years old, on the drums. Didn't they do a good job? I'm so proud of those boys. I'm so proud of them. I love them. But I'm not as refined as Ben, but one thing I learned, and it took too many years in my life to realize that that's okay. It's okay for me to be me. It's okay for you to be you. I don't preach like my brother. He doesn't preach like our dad. And thank the Lord, neither one of us preach like our brother Chuck. Sorry, Chuck, if you're watching. No, we come from an amazing family, that loves the Lord, and I'm very thankful for my heritage. But y'all, one thing about me, just to give you a quick intro of who I am, I've been mostly in my ministry, I love working with kids. I love working on the streets. I love working with rough people. Because I'm just going to be honest, you church people scare me. There was more amens than y'all realized, but everybody was too scared to say it out loud. That's what I'm talking about. No, I was raised in the church. I'm fifth generation pastor. That's right, been fifth. Five generations, Ben, is that right? I'm fifth generation. Okay. I got to check with my brother. But you know, I tell folks that there was a lot of folks delivered from drugs and alcohol and a life, horrible life of sin and abuse and abusing their bodies. And I tell folks I can relate on some of that level. I was raised as a child. I had a severe drug problem. My parents drugged me to church all the time. Whether I wanted to go or not, they drugged me. I was drugged as a child, drugged to church. But I thank God for that heritage. Now, as an adult, as a kid, when I was Ethan's age, I was probably not as happy to be in the house of the Lord because I wanted to be other places. But man, I'm hungry tonight for a move of God, for God to move on us in this place. It doesn't matter that the crowd isn't huge. What matters is who needed to hear this word tonight is here. And those that are hearing the word that aren't here are going to hear it on Facebook, because one thing about God is he's faithful. God is always going to deliver what he needs delivered, even if you or I get in the way. God will still have his way. But I pray tonight that God will use me to bring the word that he brought forth. When Pastor called me, this is the part I was going to be honest about. It's something new I'm trying in church. I want to bring honesty back, where we can just be real with each other, be honest with one another. I'll be honest, Pastor, I was afraid I wasn't ever going to get invited back. I really was. Since last year's camp meeting, I got more phone calls from some of the other churches, I guess, that were here that night. And they said, you know, you were pretty bold when you were preaching. And my first response was in the flesh. I said, I'm sorry. And then I'd catch myself. I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry as long as I'm in the spirit. As long as I'm not in the flesh, I'm not sorry for what God's going to say through me tonight. Because that's the amazing part about God and his conviction. It doesn't come from me. I don't know your sins. I don't know your struggles. I don't know your pains. But God does, and God's going to say something tonight that if you will have your hearts in tune to him, he's going to challenge you, he might love on you, and he might spank on you a little bit too. You could blame the preacher, you could blame the messenger, but the message is coming from him. If it's affecting and cutting and getting to you, then you say, thank you, Jesus. And then you get on your knees and you pray through about it. You don't get mad at the pastor for it. Amen. Y'all have an amazing pastor that I love and respect with all of my heart. You have an amazing pastor. Y'all need to know that. Brother Dustin, Brother Ben can tell you we've been in a lot of churches. We know a lot of churches that would double or triple the man's salary if they could steal him from you. No, we're not going to give you those numbers, brother. Just stay where God put you. But no, I love your pastor, and I'm not just saying that. I told Brother Bob Lynch the second I met his pastor, I said, that man is a man of God. That man, I connected with pastor the first time. He called me, and much to my surprise, I was invited back to preach again at the camp meeting at the Assembly of God in Yale, Oklahoma. So thank you for this honor. Thank you so much. So now I want to step into the Spirit. Now that my flesh is out of the way, my nerves are gone, I'm ready to lay it down. Pastor called me, and he said, God's given me a word. This year, the camp meeting message is going to be based on Psalms, the book of Psalms, chapter 80, verse number 3. Now, this is another part of my honesty. When Pastor gave me the scripture, my first initial thought was, okay, I hope he's going to invite a bunch of good preachers that can really bring some good points, because that's kind of simple. But oh, how deep it really is when I started praying through over this word. Psalms 80 and verse 3. Now, forgive me for those of you that have different translations of the Bible. I was raised on old King Jimmy. So King Jimmy's kind of what I'm used to. If you have your Bibles, I'm sure you can follow along. But the old King James in this 80:3 says, "Turn us again, O God. Cause thy face to shine, and we shall be saved." I read it over again. "Turn us again, O God. Cause thy face to shine, and we shall be saved." And I'm praying over this. And at first, you can even ask Chrissy later. I'm so blessed to have Chrissy. Y'all got to meet her a year ago. And we've been together over a year. We're engaged to be married. Thank Jesus. Thank the Lord. Her amazing family is here supporting tonight. And they have been such a huge blessing in my life. And it's good to have her best friend as well. Jack and Stacy here visiting from Bristol. Thank you all for being here. But a year ago, goodness, I turned to Chrissy and I read this scripture a few times and I said, "Baby, God's going to have to do something in me. God's going to have to give me some kind of an idea, because this at a camp meeting, everybody's probably already saved. At a camp meeting, surely ain't nobody causing division in their church. Nobody probably off track or looking at the storms in their life. So at a camp meeting, you know, this is going to be difficult to preach. Turn us again, O God, cause thy face to shine. We shall be saved." Difficult message to preach to people that should be saved. And God said, Peter was saved. Peter was looking into the very eyes of Christ when he got out of that boat. He started looking at Christ. He was following Christ. He was one of the disciples. And when Peter got out of the boat and he started walking over there to Jesus, all of a sudden, storms and the problems that were surrounding him got his attention off of Christ. So at camp meeting tonight, There might be somebody who stepped out of the boat and was following Christ, but maybe they got distracted by the storm. That was the first thing that started hitting me one day about that men and women of God, that we're followers of God, we love Jesus, but sometimes the storm can get overwhelming. Anybody could say amen to that? The more y'all amen, the quicker I can get out of here. Thank you. I knew I'd have that amen. Surprised Ben didn't shout twice as loud. Amen. There we are. That's what, hey, I shout amen for my brother when he preaches. So as I started studying deeper and deeper, and one thing I love now about the Word of God, I love to dig in deep. I don't want to just take things for face value, because sometimes we take something for face value and it was meaning something totally different when it was written. So that's why I believe the scripture says study to show yourself approved. Because if a word has several different definitions, which definition was implied at the time? Well, that's where Strong's exhaustive concordance comes in, thanks the Lord. Because I don't have the degree in Bible theology like my brother. So I've got to go and use the books to dig. And so I started breaking it down one at a time. Turn us again. I stopped right there. Ben, please don't laugh at me too much if I mispronounce the Greek. But I wanted to find the origin of the scripture. I want it in its depth of its truth. Turn us again. The Greek word for this phrase, turn us again, I believe is pronounced shub. It's spelled in our language S-H-O-O-B, shub. It means recover, refresh, restore. I like that word. And then I started applying the scripture to the word back to the scripture. Restore us again, O God. Restore us. So I went on. And again, even broke down to its own meaning. And I really wanted to get deep on this. So I went and I found the pronunciation of the Greek word for again. And it pronounces palin. P-A-L-I-N. I'm getting deep here. I'm feeling smart for a second. Google spoke that out loud for me, by the way, just so I could tell you why I was confident about that one. It's pronunciation. And you know, as deep as I would dig, the word again meant again. Restore us again. So with this scripture, it's applying to those who once had their eyes on Christ, who once were on the right path, on the right track, but yet they're begging God now. See, if you read earlier and later in the camp meeting, there's going to be more pastors preaching that gives you more depth of before and after. That they're thinking at this time in this passage of Psalm, they think God's mad at them. They're saying, God, why are you being so angry with us? We pray and yet you send more trials. And they're whining. Is there anybody in here honest enough to say that you've whined to God before in your life? Because I have. I've whined to God. Brother, I've wasted too much time whining when I should have been winning. When it goes into the scripture, the middle of that scripture where it talks about cause thy face to shine. This was an Aaronic blessing back in that time where if you went to a priest, someone Hebrew or in any the synagogue, in today's age we would say God bless you. God's blessings on your life. I'm praying that God blesses your life. This was kind of like their general generic blessing back then. God's face to shine on you. As I started studying the Greek on that phrase, the our language, the word would be O-R-E, or-e, and the word in Greek means to set on fire. God, restore me again. God, set me on fire again. Because God, like Peter, the storm got so bad and the waves were crashing so violently that my flesh became scared. I began to whine. I began to worry. I stopped winning and was whining. And the waves splashed so high, y'all, I got put out. I got put out right in the middle of ministry, right behind the pulpit. Right while sharing the word, singing the word, I got put out. My fire had dwindled. This scripture is so powerful, the deeper we allow it to talk to us. Restore us, God. Restore us and set us on fire. Some amazing things happened all through the Bible. When the Spirit of God fell. Y'all ever remember the passage about the prophets of Baal in the Old Testament? Anybody remember that one? Told y'all you better be shouting if you want to get to dinner. In 1 Kings 18:7, that's that story about the prophets of Baal. And I'm not going to read it all, but I want you to write down 1 Kings 18:37 because I want you to read later. Deeper, but tonight we're touching on it shortly so we can get to the point and get going so we can get more people here tomorrow night. Amen. In 37 Kings 18, they start to pray, thou hast turned their hearts back again. And in 38 of Kings 18:38, the first of that scripture says, then the fire of the Lord fell. So right there, in the face of all these people confused, all these people worshiping the wrong God, worshiping their job, their careers, their life, their children's careers, or whatever distraction had their eyes off of Christ. And the man of God prayed, God, turn their hearts back again. And then the fire of God fell. When God's presence shows up, things get set on fire. The end of this scripture, that restore us again, O God, set us on fire. Turn us again, O Lord, cause thy face to shine. And the last part of the scripture says, and we shall be saved. Now, anyone raised in the church, plagued with that difficulty, sometimes will immediately think of salvation. We shall be saved. That's salvation. But y'all know that there's a lot of times that church people need saved from a little more than just their sins. Sometimes we need saved from our own personality flaws. Sometimes we need saved from the very baggage that maybe grandma, grandpa, mom and dad, or maybe our spouse has put onto us. Maybe it's bound you into worship. Maybe we come to church and maybe when the fire from God starts falling and you shell up, because maybe sometime in your life somebody said, don't. Sit still in reverence in the house of the Lord. Hasn't it happened? It's happened to me. We don't run in the church. Why weren't y'all worshiping God? Why weren't you jumping up and clapping and shouting? I thought we weren't supposed to run in here. Maybe people aren't letting the Holy Ghost be the Holy Ghost because we've allowed too much of our baggage to shut down the very thing that God's trying to set us free from. Sometimes we need saved from our own intellectual mind. Sometimes we overcomplicate the Word of God. When Jesus said the greatest of anything is to love, then why in the world are churches splitting over where the devil come from or what's going to happen at the end of time if they still haven't made a sinner walking in the back door feel love? Why are you even worried about arguments over revelations if a prostitute can't walk through that back door and feel just as welcome as the preacher? Maybe we need saved from religion. Maybe we need saved from what we've made church to be. Maybe we need saved from that. There's a whole lot deeper of meaning to being saved than just having salvation. I know many denominations differ on how they teach about salvation, about sanctification, the infilling of the Holy Ghost. And you know what? I believe as an evangelist, that's not my job to indoctrinate. That's your pastor's job. Pastor and I may agree on all of it. I don't know, but it's not my place. Too many times, evangelists or people or even Christians trying to witness somebody else is too worried about trying to make that other person look like them, dress like them, think like them, believe everything in the Bible like them, and that person walks away unloved, broken, hurting, and never comes back to church. Because we're trying to make them into something, and the whole time Jesus is just saying, love. Love will save them. Love held Jesus on the cross, not those nails. Those nails could not, if a grave, if death, if a stone cannot hold Jesus Christ down, you really think those little spikes driven through his hands held him there? He wasn't held there by eschatology. He wasn't held there by denominational doctrines and a book of how we believe at this church or that. He was held there for his love for you, for me. He stayed there out of love so that you and I could be saved and not just saved from the pits of hell, y'all. He took those same stripes for our salvation is the same stripes that he took for our healing physically. If you've got an ache in your body, he's already paid that price. Claim it in the name of Jesus. If you've got an ache in your personality, price was already paid. Claim that too. Let's get it right. Here's the way I like to say it, because since I'm going to be able to leave tonight and y'all can't cut my paycheck because y'all already took up the offering, I can just preach. Amen? I can just tell y'all, it's time people in the church either get right or get left. I'm sick and tired, y'all, of people all the time. You ask people, why don't you go to church in your town? You're going to hear the same thing I hear. It don't matter if you're in Buck Tussle, Iowa, or if you're East Coast or West, you're going to hear them say the same thing.
I felt judged. I felt like they just wanted my money. I felt like they were better than me. There was cliques. I didn't feel comfortable. Where's the love? We need to be saved. We need to be set on fire again. We need to be restored again. Church, man and woman of God, we need to get things back right with God. Inside church, outside church. Listen, let me give you a side note. This part's free. This isn't written down. If you say, well, you know, I just couldn't enjoy worship tonight. This was loud or that was loud or Ben's piano kept turning off. I think that was Ben's fault. We've got a good piano. We paid a lot of money for it. Y'all are laughing, but there's people that can't worship because of stuff like that right there. Their mind has taken the storms of their personality has stripped them from being saved in church. If you're having difficulties worshiping God, when that kind of worship happens, then you've got a problem bigger than the church, the worship, the volume, the music, the instruments. Your problem is with you and God. So don't bring it to your preacher saying, well, brother, I need to talk to you about some of these things. Y'all, I've seen churches split over drums. I've seen churches split over the color of carpet. I've seen churches split over the color of paint on the walls. God, save us. Save us. Save us. The Greek word for shall be saved, for that phrase, is Yahusha. 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 To be open wide, to be set free, to be safe. Here's my favorite. To have the victory. When we go back and we look at this word, turn us again, O God, restore us. Cause thy face to shine. God, set us on fire. Restore us. Set us on fire. Yahusha, give us the victory. Give us the victory. Set us free from the bondages of religion. Set us free from the bondages of my personality and my likes and my dislikes of church. Well, I like hymnal music. Well, I like worship music. I like Jesus, y'all. Let me give you a little insight to my personality. One thing about my personality, and I know it's wrong, and I'm just going to admit it ahead of time. It's wrong. I know. I shouldn't be like this. But now I'm going to tell on myself. When somebody says, I have a poem I want to share with you, I expect it to rhyme. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's hard. People walk up to me and say, I have this beautiful, beautiful poem. Listen, Jonathan, I got this poem. Just happened the other day. I wrote this poem because of your posts, and they're so encouraging. And here's my poem. Jonathan's posts are so encouraging. God, they lift me up and make my day good. And it's wonderful, and I'm thankful for Jonathan being my friend. Y'all, it was so precious. But the whole time I'm sitting there thinking of words that would have rhymed with what they ended their sentence on. Yeah, does anybody else ever do that? Anybody? Okay, thank God. I'm not the only one going to hell or going to the altar for that tonight. Okay. But that's one of the things that annoy me, that stands out sometimes. It's like a clashing cymbal to me, and it drives me nuts. Sometimes songs will even have that where it could have ended on a rhyme, and it didn't. I'm like, ah. But you know what? I love this woman so much. With all my heart, God put her in my life, that I'd do anything for her. And I've never, ever felt the love from God, from anyone else. I tell her all the time, I felt this love from my mama and from my mama Susie. But no other woman has ever allowed me to feel the love of God, someone that cared so much. I'm going to tell y'all something. I want you to see this picture. I'm not just only bragging on my woman. I want you to hear this. Church people, hear this. If you were to come up to me and read to me a poem that you wrote about how amazing she is. I'll love every minute of it, whether it rhymes or whether it doesn't. Whether it makes any sense or not, y'all follow me. I'm going to stand there and love it because I'm madly in love with who you're talking about. Sometimes, church people, we get so caught up with our personality defects, whether it rhymes or not, whether it's the right style or not, whether it's got drums or shouldn't, whether it's Southern gospel or contemporary. And we're sitting here splitting hairs, sinking into the sea in the middle of our storms. When if we could just focus back and put our eyes on Christ, the one who sets us free, the one who sets us on fire, look to him, and we shall be saved. Saved from that kind of junk that's ruined more Christians, more lives, and more churches than I care to remember. Y'all, don't let our fleshly defects of our personalities cause us to be the one crashing waves that puts the fires out around us at church. Let us be the ones that sets the example of keeping our eyes on Christ. These songs are singing about that person you're supposed to love. So shut up and love it. Did y'all hear that? But Jonathan, what if some rap groups walk in the back of our door of our church, they walk up there and they try to do that rap junk? What if that? We got to have some standards here. Y'all, I used to live that way. I don't like rap. I still don't enjoy it. But I hope they watch this video. I met the coolest rappers you would ever meet. They were on America's Got Talent. Their name's Mike Bone, Little Mike and Funny Bone. These guys love Jesus more than most church people I've ever been around. They write their own songs, and they get up and they rap and sing about Jesus. I never gave rap a second thought. I used to hate it. I used to say, I'm going to do a youth rally, and somebody would say, well, I've got a group that could come and sing. Kids will like them. They do rap. But, well, I'm kind of full up. We've got enough entertainment. Thanks. That was me. Because I was using my preference, my idealism, my church of how I was going to choose to let God move. And God didn't need me to limit him. Y'all, I'm telling on myself tonight. So if you fall under conviction, that's not my fault. I'm telling on me. And God said, Jonathan, if I can use a donkey, I can probably use anything. He said, Jonathan, stop putting me in church and just be the church. Stop having church and be the church. If you're hindered in worship, maybe it's because you didn't worship in your lifestyle all week long. I'm ending now. I'm closing. Last couple things I want you to write down so you can look over later this week, because I'm out of time. In Acts 19, 13 through 7, this is the story of people playing church. This is the story of the seven sons of Sceva. I don't know how to say the word. These guys saw somebody being possessed with spirits. And they said, hey, we saw Pastor do this. We saw Pastor Ben. We saw Pastor Newby. We can handle this. And they walked up. And they called out. And here's what's great when you read this passage later. You're going to find out that not only were the seven sons there, there was also a Jew. And the Bible says, chief of the priests, like one of the high one of the smart ones, smarter than me. I'm not as edumacated. So this wasn't just seven lost people. There was a priest there and these others. They went up to this man who needed Jesus. He needed saved. And all they could think of is, by the Jesus that Paul preaches, by the Jesus that Paul talks about, we cast you out. We offer you the help you need. We want to see you saved because we've seen this done before. And in that passage, y'all, church people, listen. In that passage, these people play in church. It says the man with evil spirits jumped on them, prevailed against them. They fled out of the house naked and wounded. I've been to churches where after church was over, it's like everybody was walking out the back door naked and wounded because they were playing church instead of having church. They were trying to act a part rather than be the part. God has called me tonight to get in our minds the victory, the Yasha, to be set free and to have the victory, to be set on fire, to be restored. That scripture is so deep when you start realizing Satan roars. Romans to and fro all over this earth like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. 1 Peter 5 and 8 says, we're being warned of what's coming against us. So in Psalms 80 and 3 says, turn us again, O God. Now, wait a minute, Jonathan, that's Old Testament. You're giving New Testament references. Do you think it was any different back then? They were turned away from God. They got distracted. They got the whining and not winning. They got the focusing on their storms instead of their Savior, the one who saves them from the storms. I'm going to ask Ben and the band to start coming back up to the stage so we can have a time of prayer. We need to get right with Christ, guys. We need to be saved. And for those of you that maybe have this religious background where you think these altars are for the sinners, these altars are for people. So if I go up to the church, people are going to think, what did they do? Were they at the bar? Were they at the casino? Y'all listen. These altars are for people, for imperfect people who need a perfect Jesus to love on us, to heal us, to help us, to save us, to restore our passion, our fire for Him. Listen to this phrase. I want you to hear this as we end. I love this. This statement was in, I believe it was a Matthew Henry commentary. This was so deep. About this scripture, no matter how fierce the foe or how dire the situation of captivity, the shining face of God ensures both victory and liberty. Victory and freedom. The most powerful thing as I look back at this scripture now is the simplicity of this. It starts out begging God to turn us. God, turn us back around. We're off track tonight. Listen to me. I know we're off track as a people of God because the church should have been packed. When we know in Hebrews it says, do not forsake the assembling together of yourselves, even so much more as the end of time approaches. Y'all, we're in the last times. We're in the last days. This church ought to be full. We ought to be putting speakers in the parking lot for others to hear the word of God. God gave me a vision of how to make that happen. Does anybody want to know? God gave me a vision, Pastor, of how we can see all of Yale, Cushing, driving, people driving from Drumrun, Bristow, Oklahoma City, Tulsa, all to come to Yale. If somebody would catch on fire, if somebody would allow God to restore their love, to come back to their first love, fall in love with Him again, to where when you walk on that water with Jesus, Yes, we've all sunk. We've all taken our eyes off of him. We've all done that. But stop looking back at that and look back at him. Walk on that water with Jesus. And people are going to want to see what kind of church you go to. When you're walking on water with Jesus and you're in the hospital and they see the peace of God in your life, they know you have something that they're missing. Y'all, you want to see your churches filled? We got to catch on fire again. We got to be restored again. We got to be set free again, free from religion, free from our own expectations of what church ought to be. The simplicity of the power in this scripture to me now is this. In the beginning, it's saying, God, turn us back around. But it's also saying, God, turn to us. Turn us, and God, turn to us. Doubly powerful prayer. Turn us, and then turn to us. We need God tonight, y'all, to turn us back around. Our marriages, our relationships, our neighbors, the relationships we have with the guy that lives next door. He blew his lease on my lawn, Brother Jonathan. You don't understand. I can't stand him. Love. Perfect love, or don't talk to me about your beliefs and anything else. Because we're failing at love. Turn us, God. Restore us. Set us on fire.
My sleep is gone. My heart is full of sorrow.
The altars are open. If anybody wants restored.
Lord, I can't believe I let you down. Lord, I dread the pain that waits for me. Forgive me, Lord, I need your grace to make it through, and all I have is you, Lord, I'm at your mercy, Lord, I'll serve you until my dying day, until my dying day, to help others find their way, I'm at your mercy. Lord, I can't believe the God of earth and glory would even take the time to care for someone like me. But then I read the Bible, I read the old story.
Yeah, come on, sing.
How Jesus, he pled for your and my forgiveness while he was dying on. Please forgive me. I need your grace to make it through. Lord, all I have is you. I'm at your mercy. And Lord, I'll serve you until my dying day. Until my dying day. To help others find the way. At your mercy, please forgive me. Lord, all I have is you. So please forgive me.
In 2 Chronicles 7 and 14, we are promised this. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, turn from their wicked ways, and seek my face, I will hear from heaven and heal their land. If we need healing in our bodies, we need healing in our minds, our lives, and our Christian walk, all we gotta do is humble ourselves seek his face, turn from our ways, and we will be healed. Heal.
You know, you're here tonight and you're probably wondering, why in the world has God let me go through what I'm going through? Why is this happening to me? Why is that happening to me? Why every time I turn around does it seem like there's something there? Am I doing something wrong, God? Listen, sometimes God puts something in the way to get your attention. Sometimes it takes that mountain to get your attention. I told someone just the other day, they're like, I prayed for this answer from God, and immediately I got this answer, and the answer was, be patient, wait. And it was a little frustrating to the person praying, and I said, listen, you need to thank God that he answers you that fast.
I faced a mountain that I never faced before. That's why I'm calling on the Lord. And I know it's been a while, so Lord, please hear my prayer. Jesus, see you like I never had before. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes a troubled sea. Sometimes it takes a desert. Sometimes it takes a desert
to get a hold of,
to get a hold of me.
Aren't you glad his love is so much stronger?
Your love is so much stronger
than whatever.
Than whatever troubles you need. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you in me.
I know every one of us can relate to this right here.
Forgive me, Jesus. I thought I could control whatever life would try to throw my way. But this, I will admit, it's brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed to say. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes a troubled sea.
But aren't you glad he's willing to get your attention?
Sometimes it takes a desert
to get a hold of you and me.
To get a hold of me.
But his love is so much stronger.
Your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles you need. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you in. Sometimes it takes a mountain.
Sometimes a troubled sea.
Sometimes a troubled sea.
Sometimes it takes a desert.
Sometimes it takes a desert
to get a hold of me.
To get a hold of me.
Aren't you glad his love is so much stronger?
Your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you in. Sometimes
aren't you glad you can say, Lord, I believe. Jesus. Aren't you glad God's willing to be there in the midst of the storm? No matter what you're going through, He's with you if you belong to Him.
Hey, Dusk, Ben, I know y'all got one. Let's do this together as a congregation. Then y'all singers, do that same key. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full. They sing, there's the things of earth will go strangely dim. If your eyes are on the storm, turn your eyes on Jesus. If your eyes are distracted on maybe your child has a health problem, turn your eyes to Jesus. And those problems, as that song says, will grow strangely dim. All of a sudden, they're not as overwhelming when we're looking at Jesus. Amen. Beautiful words. Sing another song.
Not really. Just mumble the way. This song says Jesus is with me. How many knows He's with you? How many really knows that He's with you? Well, Jesus is with me when the storm clouds gather. He's standing by my side when I hear the thunder roll. He holds my hand when I begin to tremble, when the winds of this world are blowing strong. Yeah. Jesus is with me when the storm clouds gather. He's standing by my side when I hear the thunder roll.
He holds my hand
when I begin to tremble, when the winds of this world are blowing strong. Listen. Jesus is a fence around His children.
His grace is sufficient to stand the storm.
His word is a promise that you can stand on
when the winds of this world are blowing strong.
Jesus with me when the storm
He's standing about my side
when I hear the thunder roll. He holds my hand when I begin to tremble, when the winds of this world is blowing strong.
If you've been caught up in the winds of this world with no joy in life at all, just give your heart to Jesus. Always hold on to His hand. Never, never
God's with me when the storm clouds gather. He's standing by my side when I hear the thunder.
He holds my hand
when I begin to tremble when the winds of this world are blowing strong.
If you've been caught up in the winds of this world with no joy in life at all,
here's what you gotta do.
Give your life to Jesus, always hold on to his hand. Never, never let him go.
Jesus is with me when the storm clouds gather. He's standing by my side when I hear the thunder roar. He holds my hand when I begin to tremble when the winds of this world are blowing strong. Jesus on the main line, I tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line, I tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line, I tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. If you're sick and you want to get well, tell him what you want.
If you're sick and you want to get well.
If you're sick and you want to get well, I tell him what you want. Jesus on that main line now. I believe in a God that set the captive free. I believe in the blood that flows from Calvary. Does anyone love Jesus? Does anyone hate sin? Does anyone believe that Christ is coming back again? But what God wants me to ask you, what he needs to know most, you say he's sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost.
Sing it, listen.
I'm so glad that the Lord saved me. I'm so glad that the Lord saved me. If it had not been for Jesus, tell me, where would I be? I'm so glad that the Lord saved me.
Sing, he saved me.
He saved me. He saved me. He saved me. He saved me. If it had not been for Jesus, tell me, where would I be? I'm so glad that the Lord saved me.
You're saved tonight, Pastor Newby. Thank you.
Slap your neighbor and say, neighbor, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. We're just getting warming up. Ain't there a song, I'm just warming up? Dustin, ain't there a song that says, I'm just warming up? I'm just warming up. Ain't there a song that says, I'm just warming up? For that meeting in the sky?
I don't know it. I don't
you
know
better
it.
Learn it, son.
I'll learn
you
it.
You better learn it.
I'll get it learnt.
Oh, my. Give these guys a big hand. They've been a blessing to us tonight. Ben, Dustin, Jonathan, we love you guys, all the boys. Bless you guys so much for coming tonight, worshiping and leading us in worship tonight. Thank you, Brother Jonathan, for stirring our heart tonight, my friend. Praise God. I tell you, folks, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. I encourage you to come back tomorrow night. Come expecting, come believe. We know Brother John's going to bring it. He's going to preach hellfire and brimstone. He's going to light your fire. If your wood's wet, he's going to set it on fire. So come back tomorrow night. Be praying over. Tell somebody. Tell somebody about Camp Meeting. More so, tell somebody about Jesus. Tell somebody about Jesus because he's coming, folks. Jesus Christ is coming whether we're ready or whether we're not. He's coming. So let's stand to our feet tonight one more time, and let's just lift our hand toward heaven, and let's praise God and say, Lord, we thank you for turning our hearts again. Lord, we thank you for causing your face to smile upon us. And God, we thank you tonight, Lord, that we have the victory. Lord, we just thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost tonight. Lord, lead us and turn us. God, whatever you're going to do in this season, Lord, don't do it without us. Lord, whatever you're going to do, wherever you're going to go, Lord, don't do it without us. Father, we're praying, God, get us in position. God, get us in position for your glory. God, get us in position for your usableness. Father, we thank you tonight, Holy Spirit. We want to honor you. Thank you for coming by, Lord, and blessing, Lord, and challenging, Lord, encouraging, Lord, inspiring us tonight. Father, we thank you for healings in the house. We thank you for the deliverances tonight, Lord, that are yet to come. Lord, we thank you for the harvest. We want to praise you, and we give you all the victory in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Hook somebody's neck, shake the hand tonight. Good to have all of our guests with us from Bristol. Lord, love you. Lord, bless you tonight. You're dismissed in Jesus' name. Take us out one more time, gentlemen.
Bye.